she and Thor seldom knew a moment's sobriety, whether brutally dealing with their enemies or just as brutally raising those boys.
What do you mean?
Oh, little brother. I know you didn't have an easy childhood, but you can't fathom how much worse it can get. Imagine learning discipline by having thrashed into you time and again. That was Thor's approach, the same one Odin used on him. Poisonous notion of manhood passed down through generations. A grim inheritance, leaving all of them the poorer.
Well, Sif doesn't drink anymore. Neither of them do.
I am quietly flabbergasted to hear it.
I get the sense it's more recent for him, but I know he loves his dog.
I expect that's the explanation.
Set that aside for now. Come.
Keep on it!
Hurry!
Those springs, brother!
Atreus, you are getting better, faster.
I'd even be better than you one day, huh?
If you are not, I have failed.
Lad, I've been trying to envision how Thor and Sif came to be such better parents to Thrud than they were for Magni and Modi. That's how I imagine it.
No more for now. Focus.
Oh, a relic of some sort. Doesn't seem to do anything, does it? Odd. I've been trying to envision how Thor and Sif came to be such better parents to Thrud than they were to Magni and Modi. Here's how I imagine it. Sif goes straight in hopes that raising a good daughter will redeem their past failures. Thor struggles. Maybe she gives him an ultimatum after some breaking point or other.
Like what he did to Modi, that night he found us.
Oh, that's a deft guess, lad. And if that ultimatum worked, well, good for them. Truly.
That's so weird. We must have been to this part of the lake 100 times, and I've never seen that building before.
Aye. Strange, isn't it? Let's take a closer look.
Amir, what else do you know of the mask?
Only that it was the great passion of Odin's life. He journeyed across Aegir's burning ocean into the heart of the...